So welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin, where we're going to take a look at Ubuntu 5.04, the Hoary Hedgehog. So this came with the kernel 2.6.10. So let's get straight into the installation, shall we? So as we begin to celebrate 20 releases of Ubuntu with the upcoming 14.04 trusty, we're going to be looking at different releases, and here we're looking at 5.04, the Hoary Hedgehog, and we need just 24 meg of RAM for this. I don't know how well it would work with some of our applications, but if that's the minimum requirements, they're the minimum requirements. So this goes back to 2005, so that's where the 5 comes from, and 04 being April. And of course, during the install, we set up our normal locale information. So we can see that going ahead at the moment. And we're detecting now our hardware. With this complete, we're then going to set up our hostname. So we're going to use the hostname of Hoary for Mr. Hedgehog. And with the name set, we're then going to go through, detect the disks that we've got, and run through the partitioner setup. So we're going to use the default using the entire disk. We set up our proposal and we have to choose yes to select and move from no through to yes. With the installation complete, we're then prompted to set up our time zone information. So we can do this and then create our user. So first it wants a full name, but I just put in my first name and then a username and password. As always, the username is going to be 8 characters and is lowercase. With grub installed, we're then ready to reboot after the first part of the installation. So as we reboot and then continue with the installation, we are prompted for our screen resolution. So we're set to 1024 by 768. Choose OK on that and then continue. So then our graphical desktop, we can log in as the user that we created. So in my case, Andrew, and setting up the password. And then we're presented with the desktop. We've still got very much a brown theme. We can see we've also introduced the tagline Linux for human beings. But now we get a bit of a sparkly desktop rather than the plain muddy desktop that we saw with the first release of Warty Warthog. When we look at Mozilla, we can see we've progressed a little bit from 0.98. And when we go through to the help menu, we can see now that we are at least using a version after 1.02. And then closing this down, we're able to open up then our command prompt. And we should be able to report on the version numbers. So we'll be able to see by using uname the version of the kernel, so 2.6.10. If we look at lsb underscore release minus a to look at all fields, this looks fairly normal apart from the description where they've put Ubuntu and then the Hoary Hedgehog release rather than just Hoary Hedgehog. As we look at the memory, we should be able to see that Ubuntu uses most of the memory but puts it across to cache. So you can see that out of the 504 total, 367 is free as file system cache. When we look at our disk systems, we can see that we're using 1.4 gig for the installation, but this includes the applications like OpenOffice, etc. So this gives you an idea of what was available from Ubuntu in the first quarter of 2005. We'll leave you there, but come back to the urbanpenguin.com soon to see the rest of the Ubuntu family.